Wait a minute. Is that airdrop moving? Oh my god, it is! What the heck? I don't think I've ever seen that before. I thought it would have gotten like stuck at the top or something. That's so weird! Wait! That's a guy! Oh my god! I feel so bad! He was just waiting for the thing to come down! Look, it just finally reached the bottom. That guy was probably so happy that the airdrop was coming to him. I feel bad for killing him. F in the chat for that player, guys. F in the chat. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Exotic Gaming, and today I'm back with another super exciting and extremely helpful PUBG Mobile video. We all want to be pros in this game, and to be a pro, there are a lot of things you have to do differently from the average player. I've gotten so many questions from people asking, "Hey Exotic, how do you become a pro?" And I decided I'd finally answer that in this video. Today we'll be going through as simplified as possible of a guide for you guys to learn how to become a pro in PUBG Mobile. These are 10 things a pro does in this game. If this video helps you and you thought it was made well, please leave a like down below and subscribe for tons more PUBG Mobile content on the channel. Hope you enjoy, and let's jump into this. So the beginning of this video, we'll focus on some of the more well-known tips and tricks that are an absolute necessity to survive in a normal game. If you don't follow these steps, you will not finish with consistent chicken dinners. The first thing a pro will always do in PUBG Mobile is know the right places to land. If you're with a squad, land together close to your teammates, so if one person gets knocked, you'll be able to revive them. If you're solo, land at areas you know have good, consistent loot. You can either take big risks and land at the high traffic areas like military base, casino, or school, and yes, those places will give you the most amount of high grade loot, but you may also want to consider an area that gives you a better chance of surviving early game. Land at a cluster of buildings like here, or here, that you think may have less people nearby so you can peacefully gear up without instantly dying in the very beginning, and definitely take into account where vehicles spawn in the map. Oh yeah, talking about vehicles, let's talk about number two. The second thing a pro will always do in PUBG Mobile is know where the vehicle spawns are in the map. This is a given. You know the maps in PUBG Mobile are big, and unless you're playing in war mode or something, the circle will inevitably get smaller and smaller. If you land at the far edge of the map, you're going to have to fight the ever-decreasing circle size in order to get into that safe area. Sometimes, yes, you can run if you're pretty close to the safe area, but what if you're 2,000 meters away? It won't end well for you. If you look at these two pictures I'll put on the screen here, you can see the guaranteed vehicle spawn points on the map Erangel. And if you're looking to see where vehicle spawn points are in the maps of Miramar and Vikendi, I'll provide links to websites explaining in depth down below in the description. Check them out if you want more info. However, this is a simplified video, so we can't cover everything unless we want it to be like a 45-minute long video. The number three thing pros do in PUBG Mobile is perfect their settings so graphics are the best on their device, all while allowing the game to run smoothly. You can have a $100 phone and you can still run this game above 30 FPS if you do things correctly. A few tips would to be clear out as much storage as possible from your device by either uploading all of your photos and videos to the cloud so they don't take up space, or deleting unnecessary old text messages, or you can reduce memory usage by clearing out the app every once in a while. After every 3 to 4 games, you should exit out of every app you have open, restart your device, and reopen PUBG Mobile. It'll help. You can also check out my video linked in the description explaining more in depth how to increase FPS on both iOS and Android. It's a good video. I want to move on to number four though, because we only have so much time for this video. The fourth thing pros always do in PUBG Mobile is watch other pros in the game and study them. I am by no means a pro myself, but if I wanted to become one, I would go on YouTube and find videos of some of the top PUBG Mobile players and study their playstyles. Think about it like a football game. If you're on one team and you're facing your main rival team, and it's questionable whether or not you'll win, your coach will play videos to show you their play style so you can strategize and see how you can beat that. It's the same thing with PUBG Mobile. Why play exactly the same as other pro players? See what everyone else is doing wrong, watch how they die, and practice being better than each of them in that aspect. I promise over time, this will be the best way to become a pro in this game. The fifth thing pros do in PUBG Mobile is something a little more obvious. They never carry an inventory full of unnecessary items. Say you land first at school and find yourself a shotgun and pistol, but later on, after you kill a few people, you get yourself a SCAR and a UMP. Why would you still carry your shotgun ammo, shotgun choke, and .45 ammo? It seems like common sense, but a lot of people forget to do that. They get so caught up in the game with a bunch of useless items, and then later on when, say, for example, they kill someone by an airdrop and have to loot quickly, they have no more room in their backpack and have to sit there for a while throwing stuff away and finding room. Then they just get shot in the back. Don't be like that player, and make sure to always have space in that inventory of yours. Another awesome tip I can give for players that pros always take advantage of is speed. Yes, you heard me right, speed. Exactly what I'm talking about when I mention speed? Running speed. Pros know how to run the absolute fastest in this game. If they can't find a car and they're running to get inside the safe area, they'll first pop some painkillers, then an energy drink, then they'll unequip their weapon and just start running. Without a weapon equipped, they can run way faster, and you can too. You'll be amazed how many more times you'll actually survive the zone if you unequip your weapons and simply use painkillers, energy drinks, or adrenaline shots if you're lucky. Always be sure you have a few of those in your inventory at any given time. The seventh thing pros do in PUBG Mobile is always wear armor or helmets that aren't damaged. Let's say in the beginning of the game, you got lucky at military base and found yourself a level 3 helmet. You're set for end game, right? Wrong. If you get into several gunfights, chances are your helmet or body armor, or even both, will be damaged. If you're not paying attention, your helmet may be so low that in the next fight, a single SMG bullet could be enough to destroy it. Then you're walking around with no helmet, and you'll die super easily. So always look at your armor and helmet health. Whenever you're looting an enemy player, if their armor and helmet is in better condition than yours, take theirs. Always keep that in mind when you're looting. Never die stupid deaths. Pros don't do that. The number 8 thing a pro will do in PUBG Mobile is learn how to not loot standing still. Now, to be fair, this is a little difficult. It's certainly a lot easier to do on the PC version of the game. However, you can still move around a bit when looting on PUBG Mobile. Think about it. What's gonna happen when an airdrop just lands and you stand still for 2 minutes deciding what items to drop or pick up? Of course, someone else saw the airdrop, and of course someone else is going to want that loot also. They'll get close and see you as such an easy target, you'll die from a single headshot. Why not try and make yourself a bit of a harder target? If you're not focused on your surroundings and your looting, you need to at least make yourself a difficult target so most players won't hit you with their first shots. Then you'll have a fighting chance. Hey, speaking about airdrops, we can mention another thing pros do in this game. The ninth thing pros do in PUBG Mobile is loot airdrops in a very specific way. There are either two ways you can loot an airdrop. The first way involves a car, and the second way doesn't. If you have a car or any other vehicle, you can drive super fast right up to the airdrop, jump out and quickly loot, then jump in and quickly drive away before other players have a chance to react. This is a bit risky, but it will give you better loot quicker. The other way to loot a drop is to never instantly go for it if you're on foot. When the drop lands, other players will be coming for it, so get reasonably close to it, maybe on a building's roof or behind a tree on a hill, and see if someone else goes for it. Chances are there will be other players around, and you'll be happy you see them before they see you. Who knows, you may even get more loot because of all the players you'll kill alongside the airdrop loot. And last, but certainly not least, the 10th thing a pro will do in PUBG Mobile is learn how all the guns work. Here's the simple truth. You can't call yourself a pro if the only guns you know how to use are the M249 and the SKS. Yeah, you may get an 18 kill game if you use those weapons, but what happens if you have a Tommy gun and an M16A4 in your inventory, Yeah, you need to know how to use those effectively too. When you play a game in PUBG Mobile, you can never guarantee you'll get your favorite weapon. Pros will practice with each and every one of them, especially in the early days of a new season when ranking doesn't matter as much, and be sure they know the dynamics of all of the different weapons in the game. You can even go into training area. Going there never hurt anybody. And hey, would you look at that? We've run out of time for today's video. We went over 10 things pros always do in PUBG Mobile, and I hope these 10 tips helped you guys out. If you want to know anything else about this game, such as, for example, when I mentioned earlier about how to improve graphics or FPS on budget devices, I have all of those types of videos linked down below in the description. Watch a couple of them. You'll be very pleased with what they have in store for you. But hey, that's it. I hope you all enjoyed this video, and I would greatly appreciate it if you left a like down below if you're signed into YouTube. It takes only a couple of seconds, and if you've watched this far, do it! Subscribe for more of the best PUBG Mobile content on YouTube, turn on post notifications so you don't miss out on my next videos for this game, and I'll see you guys later. Thanks for watching.